Hello students, welcome to the e-learning platform presented by Mechanical Engineering Department of Dr. Bapuji Saloke Institute of Engineering and Technology, Kolhapur. The learning objectives for today's session are number one, study of classification of brake and types of brake. The classification of brakes will be studied in today's session and the types of brake or the basic types of brake which are generally used will be studied in today's session. Second, study of hydraulic brake and its component. Hydraulic braking system and its component will also be studied in today's session. As hydraulic brake is nowadays most commonly used in the all vehicles, it is included in our syllabus and we are going to study the hydraulic braking system and its component in today's session. Starting with first point, classification of brake. The brakes can be classified into number of ways. Some of the following are given here. First, according to the purpose. According to the purpose, the brakes are classified as primary or service brake and secondary or parking brake. Second, according to the location. According to the location, and it can be classified as the brake at transmission system and the brake at wheels. And for the brake at wheel, it can also be classified as two-wheel brake and four-wheel brake. Third, according to the construction. According to the construction, the brake are classified into two types, the drum brake and the disc brake. In this, we are going to study the both the types, that is the drum braking system and the disc braking system. These two systems are used commonly in every vehicle. Fourth, according to the method of actuation. According to the method of actuation, the brake can be classified as mechanical brake, hydraulic brake, electric brake, vacuum brake, air or pneumatic brake. In this, we are going to study the mechanical brake, that is drum brake, disc brake, hydraulic brake and the air or pneumatic brake. Fifth, according to the extra braking effort, that is power assisted brake or servo brake and power operated brakes. And last, according to the application, that is the foot brake and hand brake. So these are the classification of an braking system. Question regarding the classification of braking system is always asked or have been asked in previous examinations. Starting with mechanical brake. Usually there are four types of mechanical brake. The first one is hand brake or parking brake, that is the brake used for parking of the vehicle or to stop the vehicle at an hill, uphill. Second, drum brake. Third, disc brake. And fourth, girling brake. The drum brake and disc brake system will be studied in deeply. Starting with drum brake, mechanical drum brake. Mechanical brakes are obsolete nowadays as a service brake and are used in rear wheels of a car used as a parking or emergency brake. The details of drum type manually operated mechanical brake system is shown in figure below. In motor vehicle, the wheel is attached to the drum. The drum encloses the complete its brake mechanism and protects it from the moisture and the dust. The inner side of the drum is open. The backing plate at open side of brake drum completes the brake enclosure and holds the brake assembly. The brake drum is shown in dotted line, whereas the backing plate is shown at above side. The backing plate is attached to vehicle axle housing and acts as a base or frame for fastening the brake shoe and operating cam mechanism with its linkage. The wheel attaching bolts on the brake drum connects the wheel and the drum. The two semicircular brake shoe having brake or friction lining on the outer surface is shown in figure. The brake shoe are hinged to a back plate at one end by anchor joint, while other end rests on the cam or toggle. This cam or can be turned by camshaft, which passes through the hole in the backing plate. The camshaft is operated by the brake pedal and linkage by the brake pedal through linkages. The brake shoe are pulled inward or held by a retracting spring, which is not visible in this figure. When brake pedal is pressed, the cam turns, expanding the brake shoe outward against the spring force. The brake lining comes in contact with the brake drum, causes friction between them. This force of friction opposes the direction of rotation and reduces or stops the vehicle speed. When the brake pedal is released, the retracting spring pulls back the brake shoe inward, which in turn the cam and brakes are released. These types of brakes are also called as internal expanding brake. These types of brakes are usually used as a parking brake in rear side of an vehicle. Next is disc brake system. Nowadays, the automobile are equipped with disc brake. The disc or caliper brake has a metal disc instead of drum and pair of pad or flat shoe instead of curved shoe with the brake drum. The essential component of a disc brake, as shown in figure, are the disc, the caliper having the piston, the friction pad and the metal back plate to which friction pads are attached. The rigid metal disc is mounted on a wheel hub. The metal disc revolves between the jaws of front wheel brake and the axle housing in rear wheel brake. The friction load ride freely on each side of the disc and are held in position by machine surfaces inside the caliper casting and the spring behind the hydraulic pistons. There are generally two types, that is fixed caliper type and floating caliper type disc braking system. The fixed caliper type, the two shoes are located on each side of the disc. When driver presses the brake pedal, the fluid under pressure is sent from master cylinder through the connecting tube into caliper unit behind the piston, as shown in the figure. The shoes are forced against the disc by hydraulic pressure. The shoe exert pressure on a disc like squeezing piece of paper between your thumb finger and first finger as you picked it up. The friction between the pads and revolving disc then provide braking action, thus the wheel speed is reduced. The disc brake is of single piston caliper or double piston caliper. The master cylinder is located in handlebar of an two-wheeler. Disc brake is not self-energizing as the drum brake, as much force is needed to apply them for some braking requirement. The chief advantage of this is their resistance to fading or anti-fading characteristics. Since disc remains cool even after repeated braking system, it has longer life application. It has better cooling, it is lighter in weight, it has better anti-fade characteristics, it has more efficiency and it has quick braking action. So disc brake system are usually used nowadays in two-wheelers and four-wheelers as a main brake or as a service brake. Next point is hydraulic brake. Hydraulic brake, as compared to mechanical brake, are silent, flexible and self-lubricating. Also, they are highly efficient, durable and simple in design. The hydraulic braking system works on the Pascal law, which state that fluid transmit pressure equally in all direction without any loss. This system is designed in such a way that even brakes are in released position, a small pressure must be maintained in pipeline to protect the entire ring of air into system when cup of wheel cylinder are kept expanded. This system, as shown in figure, consists of an main master cylinder, four wheel cylinder fitted on each wheel, steel pipe, flexible hoses, brake linkage and a check wall at the end of master cylinder. When operator presses the brake pedal, the force is transmitted to the a piston inside the master cylinder through linkages. The piston in the master cylinder moves to left as shown in figure by compressing the return spring. As bypass port is covered, a further movement of piston builds up pressure in the compression chamber. When sufficient pressure is built up, the fluid check valve deflects and fluid under the pressure in the pipeline enters into the wheel cylinder. As soon as the fluid enters into the wheel cylinder, it exerts pressure on the two piston to move the piston outward. This outward motion of a piston causes the brake shoe expand, creating tension in retracting spring. The brake shoe lining presses tightly against the internal surface of brake drum. This friction between brake lining and the drum causes the vehicle to stop or slow down. As the brake pedal is released, the retracting spring pulls back the brake shoe inward to its original position. This causes the piston in wheel cylinder to move backwards. Due to this, brake fluid flow in reverse direction, that is to the master cylinder and to the fluid reservoir. As the pressure drop in the fluid line, the fluid check valve at the end of master cylinder closes. The advantages of hydraulic braking system is that at equal pressure is applied at all point in the system, thus equal effort is applied to each wheel. This system is self-compensating system. All brake shoes are not adjusted equally near the drum. Braking effect is same but all on the vehicle. A differential braking action can be achieved by using different size of wheel cylinder for front and rear wheel. There is less frictional losses as it is self-lubrication system, less wear and tear. Application of brake is very smooth and minimum moving parts. The disadvantage of the braking hydraulic braking system is any breakage or fault in system causes pressure loss and affects the whole braking system. If brake fluid leak out or on brake shoe, they will be ruined and slight leakage of air in braking system makes it useless. For hydraulic braking system, there are basic main three components. The first is master cylinder, second is tandem cylinder, tandem master cylinder, and third is wheel cylinder. These are the main three components of which the hydraulic braking system works. The first component is master cylinder. The master cylinder, as shown in figure, consists of two chambers. A fluid reservoir. First is a fluid reservoir and second is a compression chamber. A fluid reservoir contains fluid with a filler cap at the top with a small air vent to keep the brake fluid at atmospheric pressure. Both chambers are connected by the two inlet ports. The smaller one is called as intake port and the larger one is called as bypass or compensating port. A piston operates inside a compression chamber. There are number of holes in piston head of high pressure side. The reduced diameter of piston is always surrounded by the fluid. The discharge end of compression chamber fluid check valve with rubber cup inside is fitted. It serves to retain the residual pressure in brake line when brakes are in release condition. A piston return spring, and to prevent the leakage, there is rubber seal provided on both end of piston in compression chamber. When the brake pedal is pressed, the piston rod or the push rod, as shown in figure, moves towards left by moving the piston against the spring force. As it covers bypass port, a pressure is built up in the compression chamber. When sufficient pressure built up, the fluid check valve deflects and the fluid under pressure flows in the pipeline. When the brake pedal releases, the spring pressure in the master cylinder moves the piston towards right. This same force of spring keeps the check valve pressed on its seat for some time, thereby delay the return of fluid into compression chamber. This delay causes vacuum in compression chamber and there may be chance of air leakage into system. Second component of an hydraulic system is tandem master cylinder. Tandem master cylinder, in this separate fluid lines go to rear and front braking in system, and it is arranged in that if front brake lines are damaged, the rear brake lines will be still effective. Similarly, if rear brake lines are defective, front brakes are applied. This is used for the working for safety purposes. Yes, the tandem master cylinder, as shown in figure, during normal working, the brake fluid transmit to both front and rear brake when brake pedal pressed. Consider the brake lines at the front are damaged, then the piston B will move till it comes up to against the stop C. After this, pressure starts building up into space between A and B, and rear brakes are applied. Similarly, when rear brake line is damaged, no pressure is built up in the space between A and B. So piston moves freely till it comes up against B. Further movement of brake pedal moves both A and B together, thereby applying the front brake. Tandem master cylinder is useful when the braking system at either front or rear fails. Third type is the wheel cylinder. In drum type brake, as shown in figure, each wheel has a wheel cylinder. Each wheel cylinder has two piston, as shown in figure. Each piston is linked to brake shoe by an actuating pin, or end of each shoe rests on the piston. Also, there are rubber cup spreader, spring, and dust cover. The brake line from the master cylinder is connected to the inlet port and a bleeder screw to remove the air from the system. When brake fluid from the master cylinder enters into the inlet port of a wheel cylinder, it exerts pressure on piston to move outward against the drum. When the brakes are released, the brake shoe retractor spring forces the brake fluid out of the wheel cylinder by pushing the piston inward. The wheel cylinder is used to expand the brake shoes and to apply the brake. The disadvantage of hydraulic system is that if air enters into the system, the whole system is null or ineffective. So, bleeding of hydraulic brake is very necessary concept. During repair or replacement of any part, the braking system air may enter. As in hydraulic braking system, care must be taken that even small quantity of air enter into hydraulic braking system can make it null or ineffective. As air is compressible, the braking effort is not transferred to brake and brake failure occur. So it is necessary to remove the air from braking system. The process of removing the air from braking system is known as bleeding of air, bleeding of brake. The below figure shows the procedure for bleeding of brake. A bleeder screw is provided to wheel cylinder. First, loosen the wheel cylinder or bleeder screw. A piece of rubber pipe is connected to nipple of bleeder screw, and other end of pipe is kept submerged into a jar containing the brake fluid. The reservoir of master cylinder is completely filled with brake fluid during bleeding operation. The bleeder screw is then loosened or turned. The brake pedal is pressed and allowed to come up for thermal time so that the fluid is pumped through the piping system and throughout the bleeder screw into jar. Pumping is continued until the fluid coming out is seen to be free of air. Then the bleeder screw is then tightened again. Each bleeder screw throughout the system is to be treated in same manner, and any air in the system should be completely laid out for proper and effective braking. This is it. for today's session. In today's session, we have completed almost most part of our second chapter, that is breaking system. Thank you.